Hey guys, welcome to Erica's Road to the Lavish Lifestyle.
To survive, I believe that life is a prize, but to live doesn't mean you're alive. Don't worry about me and who I fire. I get what I desire, it's my empire. And yes, I call the shots, I am the umpire. I sprinkle holy water upon the vampire. In this very moment, I'm king. In this very moment, I slay Goliath with a sling. This very moment, I bring.
Hey world, how are you out there? My name is Erica. I'm the owner of Lavish Hair Studio, where your time is valuable. I want to go ahead and let you into a little bit about my life, about how I got started here at Lavish Hair Studio. How I got started, you know, I did start out at a couple salons over East Baltimore. From there, I went to a salon I owned, Mills, by the name of Sheer Joy. After Sheer Joy, I then branched out and did my own thing. I branded myself in a suite on Owens Mills Boulevard. From there, a year later, I opened my own salon, Lavish Hair Studio, where your time is valuable. We were featured last year in 2016 in Black Hair Magazine. I've been in business right now, going on my third year, and things are going great. But my number one thing out there to let you guys know and the world know that your time is valuable. In and out service at Lavish Hair Studio. I believe beauty does not have to take all day.
Hi. Happy holidays. Happy. It's beautiful today.
Yes.
Hi, everybody. Happy. Happy. Love and kisses. I love your hair. Yeah, I can see it. It's light.
I love it.
Thank you, baby Kate.
Yes.
So we ready to partake.
Yes.
Happy holidays.
All right.
Happy holidays.
Merry Christmas.
Cheers. I'm gonna get a stuffed rock.
You're
gonna
die.
That's what I was gonna say.
My Christmas party was awesome last year. I always take my stylist out every year around Christmas time just to let them know that I do appreciate them also, because they do care about, you know, my brand. Not only do I care about my clients, but I care about my stylist too.
So now you got all this competition. You have, you know, your expensive stylist who is educate themselves.
And invest,
you know,
in themselves.
Invest in itself, take care of their, you know, clients, their hair.
Right.
A lot of these people go to YouTube and they
yes.
go on
stuff.
They
want to
go on YouTube.
They don't have
their
own
hair.
Okay.
Who cares? Who likes it? Everybody's going to view it. It's you like it. That's what made it.
Yeah.
Nothing made it. Them liking your picture, that don't matter. You see
like it.
It. You know, you like your picture first because it's all about you.
Yeah.
Not about them.
Because majority of them, they don't even know who they are.
Right.
They looking at you to try and figure out who they are, who they want to be.
Oh, hell no.
And you hit that nail.
Hell no, who they
are.
Yeah.
It's so true.
She's. So us
knowing
who we are.
Yeah.
That's the best.
Yeah, that's
right.
Right.
When you know who you are,
it don't mean you don't have to work at it.
Yeah.
Right.
You know,
to love.
Some stuff.
Yeah.
We got to do better with.
Right.
Hey, but you know what? You live and you learn. And
yeah.
You learn from it and you do something about it. That's what's good, is to do something about it.
Yeah.
Change it. If you don't change it, it's a waste.
Yeah. They say if you can look up, you can get up.
Yeah. I can take another one
to
get me started on that.
There you go. I'm a food. Waiter.
Right.
I don't want to get nailed. I'm really trying to be good.
No, be good today.
You want me to be good?
You can
talk?
I want you. Waiter!
I love
her.
Okay.
Jamie
Fairley.
Yes.
Yes. You want filet mignon?
No, I've got filet mignon.
I could eat it. I don't know if it's dead.
Go ahead, it's on me, baby.
Okay. I'll have a beautiful piece of filet mignon too.
In addition to the other stuff?
And everything.
Do you want a 6 ounce or an 8 ounce?
I want an 8 ounce.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I ate
some today. No, don't drink that if that's not what you want.
What's that, the wine?
That's not your fault. That's his fault. Tell him, because that is not going to do nothing for you. It's not doing nothing for you. Uh-uh. You need to drink one of these.
Normally, when you use me and Ronnie, is in the house sleep by like 10, 11 o'clock.
It's sad.
Yeah. My mother would always be like, you getting your year ready. You sleep all early for the New Year.
Be out.
Man,
I'd
be out.
Not sleep by
like,
10.
Wake me
sleep
up.
By 10. At least watch the ball drop.
You know, Christmas dinner that night was off the hook.
I can't even imagine you with a cake.
I did.
I ain't ever seen you with a fish.
No. I got those too.
The little cat that snuck in my room, I didn't even know. Snuck in my room.
And chewed up something.
No, he snuck in the room. You know, when I left out that morning for work, I shut the door. I didn't even know Ronnie came home from work. The cat tore our room apart.
Are you serious?
Yes, it was a disaster. See, he got the worst whipping of his life. Uh-oh. And then he got put out on the bus. Drop him off
on the bus?
No, in the back of the car. Drop him off on the bus. Where he belong.
No,
he was a black kid. They don't belong in your house. They belong in the alley.
It really blew me, like.
Oh Lord!
Don't get.
Yeah, I'm about to have a whole heart attack.
You know I'm thrilled. I knew that story already. Otherwise, I would really be performing.
Perform.
Because he just ripped out my.
Listen, I did something worse to a dog. Her name was Fifi. Fifi. So I had little gay Fifi. So I ordered all my plants out, all these beautiful plants. It looked like something off an island. So I said, be good girl. Uh-huh. I went to school. I was in school. When I came home, she had torn all the plants out of the pot. Mud everywhere. So I'm not even gonna tell you what I did, but girlfriend didn't live much longer.
Oh no.
I lost my temper.
I'm like, is he really bipolar?
Not often. I'm still not ashamed of it. You should see my apartment.
Yes, service.
I had to have a service come in and clean it with mud. Like mud going between my toes and things. I just lost it. I lost it. Poor little Fifi.
It's a name they call people that hurt pets.
I'm a psycho. You're right.
Psychopath.
I'm a crazy German. Oh, and one of the girls at school gave me the dog. How's Fifi? Fine.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I couldn't tell. And she really didn't like me. She thought I was psycho anyway.
Oh, Jesus.
So she got, girl, I could never, she
you
never fanned
up,
it.
Jamie.
Yeah, right. She never fanned it. What's in that room?
Everything.
Southside. Can't get enough. Can't get enough. Peace out.
Y'all about to watch, get into a little bit of my world, my party life, how I party, how the stylists be ballin'. Birthday night, it was awesome. A Harlem's night party. Hey.
Give him fire.
I was around friends and family. Everything was awesome.
Thank you.
night was awesome. It was an awesome night. You know, we partied, we popped bottles. We got a little, it got a little crazy with me and my husband, you know, him or tapping my butt in public. Like, come on now, I'm a lady. You don't do that at all. Why is you doing that in a club? Leave that for the bedroom, sir. That kind of surprised the girl. Walking to the front, some girl was just flipping her head back and forth. I guess she was going with the wind fabulous. I mean, I don't know. But Lord, don't you know when a real girl was coming through? I was going to say something. Y'all know your stylist. I was going to say something, but I had to remember. It was my birthday night. I got to keep it, you know, grown and sexy. Wait a minute. It was all good. I let her flip her hair. It was cool. I went and had a seat. It was cool. We was all tripping out because what boss works on their birthday? That kind of surprised the girl. You got the swag, so she drip the swag. Ooh, ooh. Talking about my brother, you know, he's been away. I've been holding him down, but you know, I can't wait until I can actually see him again and, you know, get back to real business.
You will not be charged for this call. This call is from
Hey, what's up, Buzz?
What did you
say? Nothing, just finishing up working. What you doing? How your day?
Hey, man.
Oh my goodness, yo. I love my brother so much. I just cannot wait until he gets home.
Right. It was good today. Yeah, today was a good day. Can't complain. Another day, another dollar.
You gotta keep, you know, get me focused for real so when I get out there, you know what I mean? We can do the part two for real, you feel me?
Yeah, for real. Smash it. You know how we do. Wait a minute, you talking to mommy lately? You talked to mommy lately? Oh, okay, that's good. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right,
exactly. That's what you gotta do. You gotta stay prayed up over here. Yeah, you gotta stay prayed up. They be wishing on your downfall for real.
My like off days or whatever, I make sure I get his son or make sure that his son is good, and also make sure that his son, make sure he speaks to his dad or have a good conversation with his father when I'm around.
I want you to talk to EJ because I had EJ probably 2 weeks ago. I took him to the barbershop, but I think I had missed your call, so I definitely want you to talk to EJ, so you can talk to him for real. Yeah.
Cause
I told EJ, I was like, EJ, the last time I was with him, I had missed your call. So he was just like, basically, I ain't talked to my daddy. I want to talk to my daddy. I was like, all right, EJ, I'm going to let you talk to your daddy. He ain't called you. And he was like, no, I haven't talked to him in like a week. I was like, a week? How you know? That long? He was like, yes, I want to talk to my daddy. I was like, all right, EJ, I'm going to let you talk to your daddy. I'll let him know when he called me the next time. I'm glad that I can actually, you know, play a part in my nephew's life and in my brother's life. And, you know, I'm blessed to have them too.
Mm-hmm. That's why I can't wait till you come home. I miss you so much, yo. I just miss you for real. Like my other half for real.
Yeah, I miss you too for real. You know, get me, keep your head up and stay safe and stay positive and stay beautiful. You know what I mean? You know, I'll be out and miss you.
All right, boo. I love you.
All right, I love you too.
All right, bye. Yeah, you gotta stay prayed up. They be wishing on your downfall for real. That another half. And y'all know that I normally get my new nephew throughout the week or whatever, people who know me for real, but you know, I'm a family person, making sure everybody around me is good. Okay, EJ, maybe we can look and see if it's gonna be on the news. Maybe we see your Uncle Ronnie on the news, okay? We're gonna see if it's gonna be on the news. It's almost 5 o'clock. Let's see. One evening, me and my nephew was in the house chilling. All of a sudden, we see some big old fire on the news, and I'm like telling my little nephew, like, I hope your uncle not in there, you know, because my husband is an EMT for Baltimore City. So I'm like, I hope your uncle is not on these fire ground, because he's supposed to be getting off in a little while.
This fire happening around 3:30 today. You can see there are firefighters on the roof and in the first room on the second floor. We can see them working inside. That is where
you
they found the body, and that they said that's a bedroom on the second floor. This is a vacant home.
Baltimore is really sad. These people arrived. This is
just
a
disaster. Public information officer.
It's not even that hot outside yet, and they already acting a donkey.
Firefighters entered the home, and that's when they found the body. They tell us that the
shooting people in the head.